Hi, Sagittarius. I'm here to do your mid-August reading. So I pulled the cards. We've got a five-card advice spread. We've got additional advice, and then we've got an alternative message. So maybe if this doesn't resonate, maybe this will. I don't know. Well, let's get into it. Okay, so Sagittarius, some of you need to make the decision. Do not just allow things to happen. Some of you are borderline, you know, being cowardly. You have to stand up. You have to take charge of the situation and be definite and be truthful and honest about what you want and what you want to happen in a certain dynamic. Could be romantic relationship, friendship, business, whatever. But just don't let things go. And don't take no for an answer. Even when you're feeling at a place where of feeling inadequate, don't take no for an answer. Find a working way around it. For some of you, I don't know who that's for. Some of you are trying to tame yourselves in regards to maybe an outside party, you know, interference in a relationship. Some of you are trying to push that urge to go toward another person or another whatever, trying to push it down. Some of you are dealing with sexuality issues. You may be bisexual. There might be an issue of that, and you're wrestling with that and within yourself and trying to maintain a certain image. Yeah. Okay, let's get into it. All right, this is you right where you are, the devil. Are you on your correct path? It says the Five of Cups. Once again, I think you guys are trying to tame yourself from going maybe to a water sign, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, or someone with that energy. You really want to be there with this other person, but you're already in something. This devil and the Five of Cups, definitely third party. What is your main obstacle? The Eight of Swords. You just keep thinking about this person. You don't see a way out of your current situation. You feel stuck, stagnant. You're just letting things happen and you're not taking charge. What's helping you? The Queen of Pentacles. I think this is what can help you. The Queen of Pentacles makes solid, firm decisions about what he or she wants. They assess the situation as a whole, and then they execute and they make decisions in regards to everyone involved. Now, does that mean that everyone involved is going to be 100% happy with the decision? No, but you have taken in account everyone involved. Solid, clear, concise, meticulous decisions. Good business leader, owner here. How can progress be made? The Ace of Wands, right? Take action. Take the next step. Motivate yourself to move in the direction that you want to move in. Some of you are wrestling with, like I said, sexuality, trying to tame yourself in regards to going to another person. It's a lot you're dealing with. Fears of what others may think or what side of the spectrum people put you on. But you'd rather be somewhere else. You'd rather be with the Two of Cups and not the Three of Cups. All right. Crying over things that just, you know, it just can't be rectified. At the bottom of the deck, we have Page of Cups. So messages of love might come in. You may even offer someone an apology in regards to the situation at hand. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio here. All right, additional messages of support. Hobbies. So what is a hobby may turn into a full-on career change for you, or it has shifted into a business, or you need to enact or engage in a hobby because of the Eight of Swords energy that you're in. Adult children, you may have young adult children, take some more time with them. They need you more than ever at this time. Self-care, definitely put yourself first. I think you're too concerned about the masses and what other people will think, what spectrum they're gonna put you on. Self-care. Emotions. Your emotions are all out of whack with the Five of Cups. You have strong emotions for someone or something outside of an established bond, relationship, marriage. Okay? The bottom of the deck, you have, you are stronger than you know. You are. Have motivation. This is your energy. Motivate yourself to move in that direction, whatever that may be. Motivate yourself to move in that direction. For some of you, you're married. There's someone outside of the marriage you would rather be with. But you're taming yourself. You're calming that down. But you know that's not even what you really want. You would rather be with this person. Okay. Two of Cups in reverse. Yeah, this is a business relationship, a actual romantic relationship where you guys are not seeing eye to eye. Nine of Wands, you've gone through a lot in this situation. You've gone through a lot in wrestling with yourself, this situation. You want to lay it down. You want to go to the Ten of Wands and lay this down. The Tower. Yeah, what it's saying is bring the Tower down. Take action, motivation. You're stronger than you know. This faulty tower that you built up on shaky ground anyway, on lies and deceit, possibly, on manipulation, possibly, let it fall. This is you probably where you are, the Two of Swords in reverse. You just completely are letting this go mentally, like not making a decision. Two of Swords upright is knowing that you need to make a decision. You're thinking about it, you're pondering it, trying to protect your heart, your head. It's a heart over head decision. They're not aligned, so you can't make a decision. But in reverse, it's just like, well, I ain't even thinking about it no more. I'm just going to keep going, you know, with how things are. Don't do that, because then maybe either the universe will have to come in and break things up for you. You're definitely not going to like that. Or you can bring the Tower down yourself. Okay, so these are the messages that I have for you from mid-August 2018. I hope that these messages resonated for you, that you found some clarity in regards to what it is and how it is you need to move in your own life. If you feel like you need a personal reading, all of my information is below. You can email me. You can go over to the website, book and pay there. If you book and pay on the website for a video recorded reading or recurring readings, anything that is not a phone or Skype reading, there is a 4 to 5 business day wait. If you feel like you cannot wait, then you can always pay a little extra and you can do same day readings. And email me for that, because that's not on the website. I'm going to update that, but it's not on the website right now. 4 to 5 business day wait. Please, you know, I just want to say this. Don't pressure me to, once you book and pay, you know there's a wait, and you just continuously pressure me. What I'm going to do is very kindly refund your money, and hopefully we can connect at a better time for you when anxiety is not overtaking and overrunning your thought process, you know. So I don't need that display stress. And keep in mind, guys, that you know, I have an entire life outside of this. Let's just be realistic. Let me set the scene for you. Person who's interested in a reading emails me or book gets a reading online, pays for it. I see that it comes to my phone, my actual mobile device. I could be at dinner. I could be asleep. I could be in the shower. I could be actually doing something else, doing other work for an entire, completely another business that I run. I am not waiting by my phone with a deck of cards just because you booked and paid. Okay? There is a way. Let's be realistic. Let's be honest with each other. This isn't like McDonald's. Like, you drive up to McDonald's, if you eat there, I don't. And you order, and then you drive around to the window and you get your food and you drive off. No. I'm one person. This is a busy season for me. I'm grateful that I'm able to provide clarity for masses of people, but there is a way. And just like you booked and paid, guess what? Maybe 10 other people booked and paid right before you or at the same time as you. So let's just be cognitive of the fact that this isn't, you know, this isn't fast food. I guess, I don't know. I hope the analogy, I hope me setting the scene for you, it really brings you to a place of understanding. And it's not one-sided, because I listen to readers on YouTube and I have requested readings and paid for them. And I understand that there is a wait. Am I anxious? Yes. But there is a way, and I'm gonna, if you say 4 to 5 business days, or if you say 1 whole week, in my mind I'm just gonna say 7 days, because then I'm good in regards to anxiety. So 7 days come, on the 7th day I'm waiting. I might even send a quote-unquote reminder email, or like, when can I expect it today, or is everything all right, should I wait another day? Might even send that, and most times I find that the person is working on it or uploading or whatever. But let's be respectful of the fact that I have a life, and this is a hobby that's kind of shifted into a business. But I'm one person. There is no other readers. So you don't book and pay and then I pass you off to a set of readers. I wish that it was like that, but it's not like that. It's just me. And I'm grateful for the fact that you guys want to come to me and gain clarity through me, with spirit working with me. But I don't like stress. My first option is to refund money. I have no problem doing that. And then we can connect at a time where it's just better for you. Okay? So that was my little spiel. Thank you for those who like, share, comment, subscribe to the channel. It's much appreciated. I hope that these messages really permeate your mental, your soul, so that you can actually enact some change in your life. Get in the comments and let me know how this is working out for you. I got an email from a loyal subscriber, and she asked that I extend the time of when I will choose the two people who will receive the free reading. So on August 15th, I'm going to announce, I'm going to go live and announce the winners of the raffle. So hopefully it's you. All you have to do is comment below, even if you're saying hi. Comment below. All right, take care, Sagittarius.